Hello and welcome to Forever Rugby on Forever Sports. And slightly concerning news if you're a Springbok fan, with confirmation that the lock injury crisis is deepening within the Springbok setup. Archie Snyman out for a couple of weeks, will not face the All Blacks this weekend. Someone who also not available after picking up an injury against Australia. And Eben Etzebeth currently struggling with a niggle. And we have to wait and see whether he will be named in the side tomorrow. But it's a potential doubt for this weekend, which means a side that is still missing Jean Clay, Franco Mostert, Luis Diaga. Things got even worse for it. And it really is going to be a massive test of the Springbok lock depth in the next few weeks as we sort of have to look at a lot of different options, which provides opportunities for players who haven't really been in the setup or haven't really had an extended run. But it was quite concerning because the engine room being one of the most important parts of any sort of Springbok side. In fact, so much so that the original 6-2 split, for example, back in the 2019 Rugby World Cup, was implemented to be able to incorporate the sheer tremendous lock depth the Springboks have, and quite the opposite at the moment. Before we get into sort of some of the options as well as how we're going to cope, please do smash a like on the video. Please do subscribe to the channel as well. Right, so the big news is that Deon Davids is currently actually giving a press conference, and we have gotten information from it. And there's been a couple of worrying bits from the press conference. And first of all, it is that Archie Snyman is currently still walking around in a boot and is not going to be available for this weekend. It looks like he's going to be out for a few weeks and will probably only be able to play against Argentina potentially in September. Salman Murat, after being subbed in Australia, as mentioned, he is also out. So if you look at our locks, for example, they are as follows in the current squad: Eben Etzebeth, Salman Murat, Ruan Nokia, Archie Snyman, and Nicholas Jansen van Rensburg. That is five options. We are down Archie, we are down Salman Murat, which means we've only got three options in Eben Etzebeth, Ruan Nokia, and Nicholas Jansen van Rensburg. And Eben Etzebeth has a bit of a niggle, and we wait to see whether he'll be able to be fit. So if he were to also not be able to play, you'd be down to two official sort of out-and-out locks in Ruan Nokia and Nicholas Jansen van Rensburg. The other option, of course, is obviously Peter Steph the Toy, who we expect to then now probably start in the number five jersey this weekend, hopefully next year in Eben Etzebeth, and you'll probably have one of a Nicholas Jansen van Rensburg or a Ruan Nokia on the bench. I personally wouldn't be surprised if we even see Nicholas Jansen van Rensburg potentially even starting this weekend. Especially if there is a niggle to Eben Etzebeth, because if you were to, for example, start Etzebeth and a Pierce Steph the Toy, and only have one knock on the bench, for example, if Eben Etzebeth is struggling with a niggle, he goes down on match day, for example, then suddenly we go down to even fewer options. So I personally think we should probably be looking at Eben Etzebeth starting with a Nicholas Jansen van Rensburg next to him, Pierce Steph the Toy starting number seven jersey, have Ruan Nokia on the bench, then you have got four options at lock in the match day 23. If Etzebeth goes down early, you can make that switch. Nicholas Jansen van Rensburg switches to number four. Pierce Steph the Toy goes and joins him. You still got a Ruan Nokia as an option off the bench. And I think, you know, I personally would look at Ben Jason Dixon, who apparently has been training a bit at lock for with the Springboks as well, as another option. So it really is starting to really push things. And so, so frustrating that all the injuries for the box seem to be coming in the same, you know, position. I mean, at the moment, if you look at all the locks out, no Jean Klein, no Luis Diaga, no Franco Mostert, no Archie Snyman, no Salman Murat. That's five locks before you even look at a potential a niggle to Eben Etzebeth, which would make it six locks. So it is absolutely ridiculous that to have the sort of the extent of the injury crisis we have. And somebody out there saying, oh, we don't have depth at lock. We do, but we just named six players, you know, six locks who are potentially out. Now, you know, on any given day, you probably only have four of those in your squad, let alone all six. So to have those sort of six injured is a little bit ridiculous. And it's definitely going to show, I think, on the day, because first from a lineup perspective, you know, you've got nobody who's been sort of the general, I suppose, the lineup in the last few years in terms of Franco Mostert or Luis Diaga. You know, they're sort of the two primary sort of callers of the lineup. Pierce Steph the Toy, in theory, can call line. Obviously, Eben Etzebeth been there a long time. Ruan Nokia calls for the Bulls. But this is where I think Nicholas Jansen van Rensburg has been a very astute addition to this setup, because he is a line-out jumper. He is somebody who can call the lines, run the lines, for example, and I think he's going to play a very important role in this rugby championship, potentially, given the lock crisis. So we wait and see exactly what will happen tomorrow. I want to know what you think. Where would you Who would you play where with regards to this crisis, and how would we sort of add to it? In terms of other players coming, obviously Ruben Van Heerden is a player who's been on sort of a reserve list previously, and he could potentially be an option. I think something like a Ruan for Mark at the Bulls has had a really good season. He could potentially be an option. You know, you look at Jean-Louis Dupreer. He's been looked at as a lock option before as well. So you could go that direction as well. But at the end of the day, not an ideal situation. We have to wait and see exactly what will happen tomorrow morning. But very much a test of the Springbok depth at the moment. Everywhere else we seem to be pretty okay with. But locks are a problem. And nice to almost does have these problems, because you do get to explore the depth. And a massive opportunity for somebody like Ruan Okia, who could suddenly play a really large role in the Rugby Championship and put himself in that mix and really start to impress. So it is a lot of trials and tribulations. But at the same time, that presents the opportunities for players to really, really, get themselves in the mix and to show the coaches exactly what they can do. Thank you very much for watching. We will have a predicted team out this afternoon based on the feedback we get from the press conference. We'll obviously have all the team news tomorrow when it is announced, as well as the team announcement presser, as well as all the various different pressers from New Zealand, South Africa, and the likes, all on the channel throughout the week. So make sure you subscribe to the channel as well and turn your notifications on so you are the first person to hear about all the latest news right here on Forever Sports. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Steve. I'll chat to you soon.